This is the big hoss.
Oh, there he is.
All right, ready for a cup of coffee, man?
Yeah, sure.
Let's do it.
All right.
Hey, guys.
Oh. Whoa. Hey, Mad Dog.
I'm ready, guys.
No.
Enjoy the show.
Hi there, I'm Mark Lindy, and I'm the executive producer of 1North Maine. The show has been on for 15 years here in the City of Champions, and I brought back with me for his first ever television appearance, Mike Melanson.
Hi,
Mike, nice to see you.
Nice to see you.
Thanks for coming and agreeing to do this.
My pleasure.
Look, you and I were here at the beginning, okay? We decided we wanted to do something to showcase the community in a positive light. And you produced a whole bunch of episodes. You're a great writer. You're a newspaper writer by trade, but you also translated that really well to TV. Tell me about your thoughts when we were sitting in the meetings in the beginning about how we created 1North Maine.
Well, getting started was absolutely the hardest part of the whole process.
Mm-hmm.
There have been 300 episodes of 1North Maine. But the toughest part was number one, taking that first step. The 10,000 mile journey begins with a single step. And just not only coming up with ideas of what to produce and what to cover for the first program, but actually how to put the program together in terms of, you know, what do we want to cover? You know, how many different things do we cover? How much detail do we go into?
Mm-hmm.
You know, who do we want to host the show? Who do we have available as videographers? And just getting it all down on paper and getting it organized, I think it must have taken more than 200 hours of work among the various people just to get the first episode on the airwaves.
How important, how relevant do you think a show like 1North Main is in 2016?
I think there's a real appetite for people living in the city, all the people, all the different people in the city, all the different groups, just to, you know, be able to turn on the TV set and see a mirror of their community and just sort of have something to talk about with you know, their family and their friends. People are watching.
The most important thing that people still need to have is localism, and they need to see their local community in some form, and I think we bring that to them.
We are, DCA is a very vital resource for the community, not in terms of just providing the programming, producing it, but opening the doors and letting people come in and work out of a studio, work out of an organization that has that's established since the 80s, Mayor Crosby, I believe.
And, you got it.
And if you look at what's going on with the media, you know, we had two radio stations and both have closed. We still do get some radio coverage from some other sources, but look at the media consolidation and newspapers and TV. Everything's been bought up and bought up again, and there's not really a lot of room left for local stuff.
We'd cover a whole event in the community, and then besides just showing the whole event on TV, I think the impetus for the creation of the show was to take little snippets of it and kind of self-promote ourselves and the community as a result. And you'll see in a few minutes in this show, you're going to hear your voice, and we're going to see 9/11/2002. And the hairs are standing up on the back of my neck again, because obviously you and I both lived through 9/11/2001. One of the worst days in the country's history, election day, as a matter of fact, if I remember right. And it was somber, okay? The show you're about to see has a lot of fun in it, but we start out 2002, 9/11, to 2016, 9/11, and we kind of juxtapose the two of them together.
Hi, welcome to 1North Main. I'm Greg Brown. Brockton, Massachusetts, the city of champions. Today we're going to highlight some of the people that make our city great. The everyday heroes, on the front lines and behind the scenes. But first, let's begin with our top story. We begin with a tale of overcoming tragedy. September 11th, 9/11, was the day our nation lost its innocence. But out of the bad emerges some good. And here we are, 1 year later. Brockton remembers.
A solemn ceremony at City Hall in remembrance of the day America changed, September 11th, 2001. We can't forget that fateful morning, no matter how hard we try. It hit everyone hard. World War II veterans, firefighters, and police officers, all of us, whatever our age, we will all remember.
I can recall where I was when President Kennedy was assassinated. I was leaving Lyons Hall at Boston College. After class, I knew what step I was on leaving. And I find that younger folk, as regards 9/11, have the same memory. They know exactly where they were. It has made such an indelible mark on their lives.
To witness that second tower struck by the plane was just, words can't express it all. The first thought that went through my head was, all those souls that were instantly snuffed out.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
But out of the bad comes the good. Out of despair came hope and unity. We rediscovered faith, patriotism, and one another.
Thank you. welcome to the 2014 Cape Verdean Festival. What was different? What was your thought process in this?
Well, this year we wanted to do something a little different. I mean, it's 20 years later. We wanted to basically go back to the roots. That's why in the beginning you saw the little piece of carnival and stuff from the old country. And we try to keep the music as traditional as possible.
So this year, I am not going to tell you that the Cape Verdean Association is a non-profit organization. It's located at 575 North Montello Street in Brockton, in this great city of Champion. Most definitely, I am now going to tell you about these different programs that we have, such as the after-school program.
We help students with their homework and all the subjects that they are struggling in school.
I'm not going to tell you about our summer camp that we are currently running that has about 50 kids and 10 youth counselors, as well as 4 youth volunteers.
This week is International Week, where they're going to learn stuff from different countries. This Monday is it's about Mexico, so that's why we are making chocolate.
We have our own cooking show.
See? Yeah, cooking with Carla. Right.
We make chocolate.
Recently, the Haitian Community Partners held a Citizens Safety Fair at the Shaw Center.
I'm Marlene Amidi. I'm the president of Haitian Community Partners. Today it's the health and safety fair / soccer games that we're having today at the Shaw Center and the Work Stadium today. So we want the community to know that the Haitian Community Partners, it's an organization that's very vibrant in the community of Brockton. So our services varies. So we want people to come and have the opportunity to explore what we're all about.
So happy to have you here tonight for the 3rd annual gala for the HCP.
So I'm asking you tonight, as the president of Haitian Community Partners, it is a young organization. I know it's young. But again, when you have that passion for your community, that passion for the young, that passion for the old, and that passion for the little kids, guess what? We can do things. We can do things when we work together. We can do things when we put all effort collectively. We will move mountains. To the work of Haitian Community Partners, we believe in you and you believe in us. We need you as much as you need us. So therefore, we have to work together and partnering so we can make Brockton the greatest city in the South Shore.
South Shore Haitian United for Progress, we call it SHUP to abbreviate, has been in existence since 1997. We have been in the South Shore community. We are located in Brockton, and we help a lot. We do a lot of work with immigrants. We do ESL classes, literacy classes. We do a lot of immigration work. We help people to apply for citizenship. Interpretation, we connect with a lot of agencies that do social services, so we can help as much as we can the immigrant population to accomplish the American dream.
The blue sky, the shining stars, the white clouds. Who will be there to see the sun rising, the moon, the waves at the sea, the fresh breath of air? What can we do? What can we see? What can we share? Our lives, our love, our future, our way of being proud.
Good morning and welcome to the 30th annual Dr. Martin Luther King Breakfast. Injustice anywhere is a threat to justice everywhere.
This is our future. This is the future of Brockton. This is our future. You do it every minute for them.
So what does the NAACP do? They have AXO, which is an Afro-Academic Cultural Technology and Scientific Olympics for these folks. It's mentoring and enrichment. is a program of the NAACP's for grades 9 through 12. 30 different categories. The Brockton area branch is proud to have reestablished the program last year. Give the NAACP a hand clap for that.
Sasquatch, Godzilla, King Kong, Loch Ness, Goblin, Goob, a zombie with no conscience. Question, what do these things all have in common? Everybody knows I'm a monster. Love, I don't get enough of it. All I get is these vampires and bloodsuckers.
Gossip, just stop it. Everybody know
I'm a monster.
I'ma need to see up to your pants at the concert. I'ma need to see up to your pants at the concert. Profit, I get it. Everybody know I'm a monster. I'ma need to see up to your pants at the concert. I'ma need to see up to your pants.
You don't come to this every year. You don't know what you're missing.
Yeah,
this is the best.
Yes, city champion.
Johnny Walden was the best human I ever met.
Wave to the camera.
Hi.
Hi.
Greatness.
To see the crowd at the Brockton Rocks game have the dedication of home plate to the families and victims of opioid substance abuse. It was great, it really was. It was an opportunity to educate, but also support our Brockton community and family and friends.
Yeah, I think it was exactly what my mom said. It was nice to bring together the families and kind of give them that moment to recognize the issue and recognize that we are there to help as much as we can.
Shamrock that a bunch of us had after John passed away, and I pulled out at certain events, and so I had to wear it today.
I know I've got great friends. Casey and I have some great friends, but you know what? They're also committed to the same thing that everybody else on this field is. They love this city, and they know what this event does, and I think that's why they come back.
What's your role today?
My head.
It doesn't matter.
I brought him in. I brought him in from New Hampshire.
How much did they cost?
$500 a kid.
We're doing real well. Wink, wink.
Bad call by the ump.
We are a diverse group from all over, from the city and outside of the city. It gets to show what Brockton's about. And that makes, I think, my husband would be loving the fact that we're able to showcase Brockton to a whole bunch of people.
I tell you what, being this host of 1North Maine, everyone thinks this is fun and games. It's treacherous. It's dangerous. It's not easy. You're risking, you know, your life, honestly, doing different things, and it's tough. I remember one time I was interviewing Ron Van Dam. I'm sorry,
Daminator.
Yeah, I keep forgetting. So, you know, I'm interviewing him, and then he tries to be a big tough guy, real big tough guy. So we're heading to the studio chairs. He pulls me and spins me. A 360 spin from nowhere. I tear my ACL. Shattered. Done. And I had to do the interview. Obviously, the camera didn't recognize that. With a torn ACL. I mean, this guy just really was out of control. Not fair to me, not fair to Brockton, but you know what? I could step up, be a man, and do his best for the community and let the show continue, and the show must go on.
What did he say after?
He said, you're done. You're done. You hear me? You're done.
It's tough, man. What about you, Jay?
You sure you want to go there, Jay? If you don't, that's fine. I mean, I know it's tough.
I know. August 12th, 2012. Senior picnic. It was perfect. It was perfect. Billy Kudo singing to the ladies that swooning over him. Great music. Mike Brady singing along with Kudo. Nubia trained me for weeks. This was your moment. This was your moment. And I choked. I choked. I asked the lady, how much did she weigh? Diabetes, Brockton Knox Town Diabetes team was there.
A little nervous and I'm sweating a little bit.
I asked him, is diabetes that big a deal?
Of course it's a big deal. What is it?
I thought it went great. And then it happened. I couldn't find my tripod. Where's my tripod? What happened?
That's not good.
Those ladies cornered me. And they did a number on my back. I'll never.
Forgive me, sir.
Oh my goodness.
Why, Jay? Why? Why?
A tripod did that?
Why, Jay? Oh my God, I think I'm gonna be sick. Why?
This lady said to me, who was sleeping next to me, you should do a show. That was funny.
Hi, I'm Janice Fitzgerald, the director at the Brockton Council on Aging. I have got the best job in the city of Brockton. You need to come down to the Council on Aging and participate in some of our events and activities. We have a lot of fun. See you soon.
I like the activities here and Janice, the staff. They are perfect. They are great. They are so personable with everyone. And we do a lot of things here.
Look at all the purple and white. I love it. Woo!
This event, from starting the event with the idea that our activities committee comes up with, and sometimes our employees here as well, we all contribute together to the ideas for different functions. Then we have to find the appropriate caterer, who is senior friendly, of course, and then all of the volunteers that come and help support us every day, help set up and decorate for the events, help serve and bring food to the tables for people that can't get up and get it themselves. And then we have the elected officials that always come in and help us.
You will never see a portrait of my love for America. I never see.
For our second year now, you know, we are hosting the Prescription Drug Take Back with the Council on Aging. And this has been a really successful program in getting unused, potentially very dangerous and addictive drugs off the streets of our city before they fall into the wrong hands and get misused by someone.
Don't you know that you're some kind of wonderful? Some kind of wonderful, yeah, she's right. Some kind of wonderful, yeah, 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 yeah.
Hello and welcome to 1 North Main, BCA's magazine show, where we highlight people, places, and events that make our city great. Today, one of the biggest events in this city on an annual basis, the Champions Fighting Cancer Walk. It is a fantastic time. It's humbling, it's motivational, and it's powerful. Join us as we, at Brockton Community Access, cover the Champions Fighting Cancer Walk.
Hi Jay, my name is Fred Nicoli. I chair the Foundation Board of Governors, who's they're behind all of this. And I just want to take a minute to thank all of the people that showed up here today, in spite of the cold weather and potential rain on the way to the hospital. It's a great event and a very worthwhile cause.
It was a very emotional time for all of us, and personally for myself, because Karen and I have been friends for over 30 some odd years. And I took this as a personal strive for cancer, and this walk became definitely personal for a lot of members in the department.
Hi there, what's your name?
Cassidy LeBate.
And Cassidy, you brought a friend with you today.
Yes, I did. Rosie is her name.
And it says Rosie helps fight cancer. Did she make the shirts or did you?
We made them together. We sure did.
This walk, to me, you know, it's called the cancer walk, right? But it's not really about cancer, it's about people. You know, it's about people who have fought a bad disease and are fighting a bad disease, and it's about their families who just want to hold on to the memories, and, you know, so it's a great day for us.
We are at a great corner. We are at the YMCA, which is just over here. And then we have the Mary Cruz Kennedy Senior Center, also known as the Council on Aging. And come back here, young lady, come back here. You're here.
Yes, I am doing the Cancer Walk for Signature Healthcare once again. This is about my 15th year, and I am so excited.
You set a furious pace. I remember you from years past, and I tried to keep up with you one year, and there's just no chance.
No, I'm getting better and better each and every year.
Work it.
Nice. I'm represent Team Felicia. We've been walking since 1999, right? When my mom passed away, and we do this to support Brockton Hospital in their efforts to bring treatment closer to the community, and we're happy to do it every year.
Team Felicia, champions fighting cancer! Woo!
I'm Chief Williams from the Brockton Fire Department. We're standing here in front of the Strand Theater Memorial, which was erected back in the year 2008 to remember the 13 firefighters that were lost in the Strand Theater on March 10th, 1941. This being the year 2016, it's the 75th anniversary of that tragedy. And we held a special event back in March in remembrance of those 13 that perished that day.
I'd like to welcome you to the 75th anniversary of the Strand Theater fire that claimed the lives of our 13 brave Brockton firefighters and also injured many more on that tragic day.
It's so critical that we keep their memory alive and use it as a model and remembrance of the sacrifices and the risks that are taken by first responders every day. and Brockton has such a great history, and this event is a critical piece of our history. And I'm so glad that the firefighters have done such a tremendous job in marking this day every year.
March 10th, 1941, on a theater balcony that stood just feet from where we are gathered this morning, 13 brave Brockton firefighters lost their lives when the roof of that theater, weakened by the destruction of fire, collapsed on top of them. This tragedy was at the time and remains today one of the worst loss of firefighter lives in our nation's history. Each of these 13 firefighters left behind a wife and family. As a group, a total of 26 children were left fatherless. It was a day of great sadness, not only for the families of these men, but also the members of this department.
This is from the Massachusetts Senate to the family of all the 13 firefighters. In recognition of the 75th anniversary of the Strand Theater Fire, where their honor, bravery, and sacrifice transcended the call of duty, and this is signed by the President, Stanley Rosenberg, and also myself and the clerk, William Weld, and God bless you, and your memories will never be forgotten, and the memories of all the firefighters will never be forgotten.
The House of Representatives offers its sincerest recognition to all of the firefighters' families in recognition of the 75th anniversary of the Strand Theater Fire, where the honor, bravery, and the sacrifice and call to duty transcended the call of duty. And it is offered by the House of Representatives and our Speaker, Robert DeLeo. So to all the families, thank you.
Captain John F. Carroll, Ladder Company 3. Lieutenant Raymond A. Mitchell, Engine Company 4. Firefighter Matthew E. McGarry, Ladder Company 3. Firefighter Roy A. McCarrigan, Squad A. Firefighter Dennis P. Murphy, Squad A. Firefighter William J. Murphy, Squad A. Firefighter Daniel C. O'Brien, Squad A. Firefighter George A. Collins, Engine Company 1. Firefighter Frederick F. Kelly, Engine Company 1. Firefighter Martin E. Lipper, Engine Company 1. Firefighter Henry E. Sullivan, Engine Company 1. Firefighter John M. McNeil, Ladder Company 1. Firefighter Bartholomew Hurley, Ladder Company 1.
It is now time for the audience participation portion of our program. When I say who, you say Brockton. Let's practice. Who? Not bad, not bad. I plan on screaming. I hope you do too. No? Okay, here we go. We have Pox Brockton After Dark, Enterprise Block, and of course, The Rock. Who?
Brockton!
Who?
Brockton.
The Little Red Schoolhouse, a hockey rink, plenty of food, plenty of drink. Who?
Brockton!
Massasoit City Hall Plaza, the Westgate Mall. Luke, I am your father. Faja. Who?
Brockton!
Great public schools, community events, churches and nonprofits. Brockton rules. Who?
Brockton.
Now, where were we? Oh, that's right.
All right, guys, let's not get cute here, okay? We all know I'm the best host of 1North. I mean, just, we all know that. And I was the best looking one. And you know that, believe me.
You're kidding.
Believe me, okay? I was the best host and the best looking one.
No.
Okay? You got a little slick handle here from 1975. And you,
GQ.
And you just use props. Where do you get these props? What do you think?
Wait a minute. Is something in this? Are you out of your mind?
Right? I'm not out of my mind.
The fever?
No, you gotta be kidding me.
I'm not kidding you.
Dude, props? Who wore the best hats? Me. Who had the best ties? Me. Who wore the tie with the jeans? Me.
Yeah. Who wore the tie of Christmas?
Who is the most dynamic, natural individual?
Whoa. Who wore the tie of Christmas during Summerfest? You.
Christmas in July? Am I alone here? Am I talking to myself?
Yeah, I think you are alone because you're a little cuckoo.
Because I don't have that much time in the game doesn't mean I can't beat both of you.
No, you're not even close. Not even the same. You look a little pebble. We're cars going 90, a little pebble on the highway.
You guys are like rail to rail. Phased out.
Jay, don't go there. Don't go there. You seriously do not want to go there.
You know what I want.
Seriously, you don't want
you
to
know
go
what
there.
I want.
You don't want to go there.
You know what I want.
Yeah, you can't.
Let's go.
Me,
you, Mono.
Hit me!
Sit down. And you sit down to whoever you are. I can't believe the three of you. I've known you for a long time. Except you, I don't know you. You guys are professionals. What number Main Street is this?
132.
No, I meant where's the studio?
One.
That's what I meant. You guys are disgusting. You all smell too, I had to tell you that. Why don't you just get along? There's only one way to settle this, and you know how it is.
How's that?
I thought that was the end of the scene.
This group behind me has done some great work this summer. They've served the community, and they've also worked. Hence, the summer of work and learning. So Brockton, are you ready to learn more about
summer work and learning?
It started off as an internship program for high school students, paid internship program for the high school students. Typically, they work Monday through Thursdays, and then on Fridays, they usually come back to us at the high school, and they work on skills for professionalism, they work on resumes, cover letters, things that'll help them get a jump start in the workforce. A couple years ago, we started introducing the community service component to the program, and it's been a huge success. It's just a way to remind the kids that, you know, we're getting so much from the community. This is the opportunity for us to say thank you and to give a little bit back. We recognize how hard you're working at this. You know, when we look at the before shots and the fact that you couldn't even see this place, and now you look at it after a couple of weeks, I mean, the transformation is pretty incredible.
It's coming.
We really appreciate your hard work. This is not easy work. Again, if you see the before photos, this place you couldn't even see. So you did a fantastic job.
Everyone's just happy, like there's no bad vibes or bad attitudes or anything. They make sure we're all comfortable and we're all feeling good. and we're all happy, and we make kids happy too, so it's good for all of us.
I didn't have any experience in gardening until I joined this program. This program really helped me a lot in learning how to garden.
The kids love it. If we didn't have the kids, none of this would be possible, basically. They do all the hard labor. We wouldn't have enough time otherwise, so it wouldn't be possible.
My absolute favorite part of the program was definitely just helping the citizens of Brockton. I really do enjoy helping people, so it helped me learn what I wanted to do in the future a lot. And I'm very honored to be part of this program again, going on my third year.
Man, I love the holidays.
So, how you feeling about today?
I feel great. I feel great. It's a wonderful time of year for Brockton. It's 125 years since we celebrated this unbelievable holiday, and we're back 125 years later doing it all over again.
Santa visited with the children of Brockton. He listened to wishes for dolls. He listened to wishes for trains, but most of all, he listened to wishes for peace and joy. Believe you can love one another.
Tonight on Channel 9, the battle to end all battles, the quarrel at Capiello. Who will be crowned the greatest host of 1 North Maine? Who will become the man of the hour?
The Tower of Power. Twisted steel and sets of view. Tune in at 5:30 p.m. for all the action.
Ooh, I like that shirt. Well, guys.
I took care of him.
love watching you develop into young adults and figure out what will come next for you. However, we didn't just watch. We also had the incredible responsibility as educators to influence your development and decisions. We were partners with your family, the community, and we say thank you to them for working with us. You gave and you gave and you gave, and for that we say thank you. I hope and I have hope for the future because of you.
My heart ever steadfast.
Culmination of four determined years of learning and growth for this deserving group of students. Our graduating class is again the 150th such class to receive a diploma from Brockton High School since its founding. It is an auspicious moment for a nationally recognized urban high school, the largest in Massachusetts, that has brought honor and prestige to the City of Champions for the last century and a half.
You guys were pretty tough. To say you were spirited is a generous adjective.
At the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming. And the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave.
What matters is how you define success. What matters is that you find personal happiness, passion, and fulfillment in life. You did your part. Your success in MCAS, your low dropout rate, your high attendance rate, your high growth rate made Southeastern a level one district. It is safe to say that you are not only the largest class, you are also the best class.
I have come to believe that it is often our imperfections that motivate us to strive for excellence and to reach our maximum potential. Sometimes it is in letting go of the idea of perfection that true intellectual epiphany strikes us. I want to thank Ms. Connor for these few words that all of our students know too well. Get off your elbows and think.
I want to leave you all with one of my favorite quotes. Vince Lombardi once said, "Perfection is not attainable, but if we chase perfection, we can catch excellence." Fellow graduates, do not strive for perfection, because you will miss everything life has to offer.
We were all boxer buddies and peer mentors. We were and are boxers. It is up to us to decide what we do with these diplomas we are handed today as we get closer to the real world. Whether it be venturing into the military, workforce, or continuing education, after today we will all officially be boxers for life. Class of 2016, stay connected with the friends you have met throughout your high school career, along with teachers who have made an impact in your life. Don't just put it on your Snapchat story. Live your story, and congratulations.
You are watching BCA. Brockton Community Access. Excellence in public, education, and government programming.
Hey,
Ladies, gentlemen, boys and girls, boxing fans of all ages, this is it, the main event of the evening. Nubirato, Eamon Convey, Jay Miller going at it head-to-head in the ring. We are live coming to you from the Capiello Boxing Gym in beautiful downtown Brockton, Massachusetts. I'm Mad Dog Matt Nelson, and this is the fight of the century. Put it right up there at the top with the classics of all time. Muhammad Ali versus Joe Frazier. Mike Tyson versus Evander Holyfield. Brockton's own Marvin Hagler versus Sugar Ray Leonard. That's it. Let's go. Let's get ready for the action.
Ladies and gentlemen, good evening and welcome to Capiello's Gym in Brockton, Massachusetts, where tonight, the quarrel we have all been waiting for. Three of the most significant hosts in 1North Main history duke it out to see who is the most second popular host in the history of the show. Introducing first, fighting out of the red corner to my left. He comes to us from Brockton, Massachusetts, and despite growing up in the City of Champions, his parents made him take a torturous two-hour bus ride to private schools in Rhode Island all his life. He's got a haircut like Macklemore. Ladies and gentlemen, Eamon Convey! And, for some reason, fighting out of a neutral corner, the white one. He comes to us from Brockton, Massachusetts. He hates mayonnaise, but ladies, he loves long walks on the beach. Nubirato! And the current host of 1North Main, known for his KO of cancer and known for having the same name as a writer for the Patriot Ledger, but he can't write an email to save his life, ladies and gentlemen, Jay Miller! Your referee from this contest, making a long-awaited return to public access after nearly a decade, Ron Van Dam.
Come on, close. Come on, close. I don't have much time. All right. You guys know each other, so I don't want any fooling around. Don't touch Newbie's face. It's too pretty. Now, here's the deal. Don't touch him below the belt unless you're familiar with them really nicely. You've been on a few dates. Other than that, remember, this is not a talent show. You simply introduce things and then make stupid comments about them. Hey, I'm not finished. Do you want to go home now? This is sanctioned by the BCA. Brockton can, I don't know what it is. All right, do you have any questions for me? Do you want to know anything about me? This is as close as I've been to a ring in five marriages. I want you to know this is very important to me. If I see anybody talk out of line or get crazy or anything like that, I'm going to stop the fight. And you're going to go to a corner with a dunce cap on your head and you're going to sit there for the rest of the afternoon. I'm putting up with your crap. I want you to know right now. Hey! Don't talk to him when I'm talking to you. All right, go to your corners. Good luck. You're going to need it. Get out of here. I'm going home.
All right, first up, the rookie. It's Eamon Convey fighting out of Brockton, Massachusetts. He's wearing a navy blue suit and tan shoes. Ladies and gentlemen, up next, the four-time award-winning director and producer out of Brockton, Massachusetts by way of Lynn at Technical Vocational High School. He started as a fill-in host, but it became a regular gig for him. It's Jumpin' Jay Miller.
All right, Daddy's on TV.
Hats and his ties. Today, he is sporting a Christmas tie.
Jeez.
That was a tough round.
Yes. I can't take it anymore.
Drink this. Now, what's the matter with you? You sick or something?
Where am I? Marker. Give me the marker. Oh, goodness.
You got it. You're doing good. Hang in there.
Why don't you go and stand up to this guy hard like you've done before? It was beautiful.
I can't do it. I can't see anything. Freddie, I can't see anything.
You can see.
I can't see.
You're doing good. Hang in there.
My eye's hurting, but how's the hair?
Here.
The hair all right?
Yeah.
You're boring me to death. Now get up. Get out there and do what I taught you how to do.
Oh, that's better. Oh, look. It's Mother Goose.
Man, I always had a thing for her.
Oh, yeah.
Thank you.
bunch of losers.
Is it?
Tip tap.
Oh, yeah.
Chapeau, chapeau.
Chapeau, chapeau.
Chapeau, chapeau.
Chapeau, chapeau.
Chapeau,
chapeau.
Chapeau.
Get up! Get up!
Get up!
Come on, man, do it. You can get up. Get up and fight.
On your feet!
Up. Step up. Come on, step up big time.
Get up! Tag me!
Yeah.
Ha!
Oh! Come on. Slow game.
Thanks. Thanks for watching.
All right, we're here with the winner, ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the golden microphone, Eamon Convey. Eamon, here is your parting prize, as well as the 2016 Olympics gold medal. And everybody's favorite track, Music from the Mound, the Dice K Matsuzaka edition.
All right.
Eamon, what does it mean to win against two of the greatest hosts of all time?
I mean, listen, you know, Jay and Newbie. Yeah, you know, I owe it all to them. You know, everything they taught me, and I'm proud to come out on top, you know, but I'm the best. What else can I say?
Anything you want to add?
I should just take it away from here, right?
Bring it up.
I'll do it with all the mics. For everybody at 1North Main, I'm Eamon Convey.
Did she make the shirts or did you?
We made them together. Chocolate, gotta love it.
Hello and welcome to 1North Main, BCA's magazine show. I'm your host, Eamon Convey.
Now, what's the matter with you, kid? You sick? Something? Look at me. Now, why don't you go and stand up to this guy hot?
I'm sorry. All right, let's try that again.
Devastating. Devastating.
Doing that.
Is that sadly enough? Or do
you want? You're gonna get it. You're gonna get it on football.
And then he tries to be a big tough guy. Real big tough guy. So we're heading to the studio chairs. He pulls me and spins me.
Whoa!
Yeah.
So cool. Coach!
Yeah.
Whoa!
Yeah. Yeah.
Hello. Okay. Hello and welcome. I can't beat him. I can't do it, Freddy.
You can. Come on, come on, Boucher. Come on, come back, nigga. Come on, come back, nigga. Let me see Monsieur Pio Basso. Come back, Lee. What?
What?
What? What?
What? What?
What? What? What?
What?
Let's do that again.
All right.
Just, I want that.
Okay.
You know?
Action. Can't take it.
Yeah, try it again.
This is how we're gonna do it, because I'm the best, better than all the rest.